Hi, I'm Gwendolyn with iFixit, and today we're tearing down the brand new iPhone 7 Plus. While the iPhone 7 Plus retains the design basics of the previous generation, it does have a lot of upgrades, including a new dual camera system, a non-mechanical home button, IP67 water resistance, and a beefy processor upgrade. But what updates are taking place inside the iPhone? There's only one way to find out, and that's to tear it down. Getting into the iPhone 7 Plus was a familiar affair. Pentalobe screws, iSCLAC open, although with a bit more force than we've had to use before, and a little prying. But then a difference. The iPhone 7 Plus opens to the side. Have we not had some advance warning, this could have been a disaster for our display cables. Good thing we make guides. Another annoying novelty rears its head. We have new screws. Tri-point screws secure both the battery and the display bracket in the iPhone. Fortunately for us, we've come loaded with our ProTech toolkit that handles them easily. With screws out and cables disconnected, we remove the display. Heading down south to the bottom of the phone, we remove a plastic component that, according to Apple, is a barometric vent. With the added ingress protection afforded by the watertight seal, the iPhone uses this baffle to equalize the internal and atmospheric pressures in order to have an accurate altimeter. Speaking of the taptic engine, it's next to be removed. The taptic engine is a tiny linear actuator and some zigzag springs that shake a weighted core. The taptic engine's precision oscillation is designed to provide many types of tactile feedback, including the sensation of pressing a mechanical button. With those two parts removed, we have easy access to the battery adhesive pull tabs that hold the battery in place. This is a 3.82 volt, 2900 milliamp hour battery, which is a slight upgrade over the 2750 milliamp hour battery of the iPhone 6S Plus. Next out were the cameras, two sensors, two lenses, and two sets of optical image stabilization. One of the cameras is wide angle, just like the iPhone 6S, and the other is a telephoto, which allows for optical zoom. Both of these 12 megapixel cameras also sport a new image sensor that Apple claims is 60% faster and 30% more energy efficient than previous iPhones. After removing some portions of the antenna assembly, including the antenna flex cable, we get the logic board out. Peeling away the EMI sticker reveals the chips on the board, including the new A10 Fusion chip and its accompanying 3 GB of RAM, and 128 GB of Toshiba-made NAND flash storage. If you want to see the full list of chips we've identified, head on over to iFixit.com. We have a very complete list of chips, thanks to some help from our friends at Chipworks. The speaker is next to come out, and a closer inspection reveals some nice spring contacts and ingress protection, meaning this speaker is helping us keep things out of the phone, namely water and dust. Much has been made about the new models of iPhone being more water resistant, and this is just one instance of the new feature found on the phone. We also found rubber gaskets on the plugs at the SIM tray port and some very substantial gasketing at the lightning connector. Speaking of the lightning cable assembly, it's moderately glued to the case and it is huge. Attached to it are those speaker gaskets. These gaskets are a serious water and dust proofing upgrade from the 6S Plus's use of foam adhesive in this location. With the lightning port out, we turn our attention back to the display. By the way, this display is a 5.5 inch 1920 by 1080 Retina HD display with a pixel density of 401 pixels per inch. But what really interests us is down at the bottom, the new home button. It's more like a home touch sensor, really, and it is removable. It won't be a simple procedure with tiny tri-points and light adhesive on the cable, but thankfully there's no longer a delicate gasket to replace. We've come to the end of our teardown, and now we turn our thoughts towards repairability. How did the iPhone 7 Plus score? It got a 7 out of 10, and here's why. On the upside, the battery is straightforward to access. Removing it requires specialty screwdrivers and knowledge of the adhesive removal technique, but it's not difficult. The solid-state home button eliminates a common point of failure. Improved water and dust protection greatly reduces the need for repairs associated with environmental damage and accidental spills, but it also makes some repairs more difficult. The display assembly continues to be the first component out, simplifying screen repairs, but the procedure has grown more complicated with improved waterproofing measures. But on the downside, with the addition of tri-point screws, many iPhone 7 Plus repairs will require up to 4 different types of drivers. And that's our teardown. For the complete teardown, including tons of beautiful, high-quality images, head on over to iFixit.com. Don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel to stay up to date on all our latest teardowns and repair videos. You can follow us on Twitter at iFixit and give us a like on Facebook at facebook.com/iFixit.